of you who came in late, make sure you grab some dinner if you haven't eaten already.
Hello. I'm Kim Paul. I'm a colleague over there in the lobby. And you are representing AIESEC today? Tonight we'd like to share with you our recommendations for Givology as organization seeks to expand. And our particular approach focuses on strategy rather than tactics. Our presentation encompasses four areas. First, we'd like to share our interpretation of the Givology model. Second, the challenges we perceive Givology facing as it seeks to expand. Third, where we see Givology going in the future. And finally, we'd like to present a few partners for Givology. Now, we see the Givology model encompassing three different areas. The first are the stakeholders. There are four stakeholders: donors, the Givology portal itself, partner organizations, and of course the children. Now, each of these partners has particular interest within Givology. The donors are looking to see the greatest return on their investment. Givology is looking to maximize social impact. Partners are hoping to secure sustainable funding, and the children are hoping to add value to their lives. Now, Givology chooses its partners through screening. This screening is an application process that consists of the partner's purpose, its operation, legal status, and an assessment of current social impact. And this is also supplemented by a third internship. And the investment. This diagram shows the flow of funds through the Givology model. Donors invest in the future of children through the Givology portal. And Givology pools these donations into donor pick project funds. These funds are released to partners according to the stipulated agreement. And return. Donors realize returns directly from their investments by tracking the progress of individual projects. And the Givology portal allows for direct interaction between the partners and the children. And once the donors see the positive returns on their investment, they're more likely to invest further in the future. Now, we attribute the success of Givology to its progress in communication, the dedication of its founders, and the credibility of its transparency.
So, as Givology looks to scale up, we feel that it's going to face two particular problems. First of all, partner organizations are going to have to be chosen systematically. And the problem Givology is facing right now is basically that partner organizations just come up to them and apply for funding, essentially. And Givology is going to have to be a lot more proactive in this process. Secondly, their core competency is transparency. If investors cannot see the return that they're getting on their investments, or the donors do not see the return they're getting on their donations, they will not continue to donate. So while they scale up, they have to make sure that this remains. However, we do believe that Givology has the potential to add something more to the lives of a lot more people abroad than just the channeling of funds. Okay, so addressing the first problem, partnerships. The first, there are basically two approaches Givology can take to address this problem. The first is they can have a global standard, which basically means that they have set criteria, set application, a set interview process, a set number of metrics which they will use to analyze each and every project, and then basically rank projects and select them. The second one is they can choose to be totally locally responsive and essentially outsource or let someone who's more aware of the local community wherever they're investing, let them handle that bit, right? Now, the problem with that is that, is again, the problem of standardizing across the world. But we do feel that the second approach is a much better approach, because that will allow Givology to focus on their core competency, which is ensuring transparency. Now, if Givology can do that by partnering with legitimate, well-renowned organizations abroad, they can basically not only reach out to different local communities in different countries by partnering with these guys, they can also have a greater degree of transparency and a greater degree of feedback. So that gets me to this slide, which is basically We believe that a reduction in communication costs has enabled such a model to be possible. Okay, that's pretty obvious. The internet has enabled such this kind of thing to exist. Secondly, in order to maintain transparency, Givology has to consistently improve and monitor its feedback system, which basically goes in line with what we meant by Givology having to be locally responsive. Now, the reason Givology cannot do this themselves is, well, resources. Shortage of resources. They want to do what they're good at, they want to do what their value proposition to the customer is, not go do something else. Therefore, we recommend the presence of the presence of credible endorsements for their projects. These endorsements can be in the form of partnerships with people or organizations in those countries which basically find projects for them and recommend them. Right? And the first thing, we believe that they should have a reputation system for projects. What I mean by reputation system is something that has been discussed by one of the earlier groups. It's basically people who have donated for the projects go ahead, tell their friends about it. They don't rate it on the website, they have blogs, they talk about their experience, they talk about how they felt when they donated and how their experience has been. Right? So, the third thing, we believe that Givology has a lot more to give, lot more to offer than just the channeling of funds. Because what Givology has managed to set up right now is a network. And a network is one of the most precious things, right? Fortunately, we believe that there are so many things that can circulate through a network, apart from money, that Givology can have a lot more social impact just through using that network. One of these examples is knowledge. So if you have an entrepreneur, or if you have someone who wants to start up something, and a not-for-profit in a country, now, these guys normally don't have they might have the monetary resources, but they might not have the knowledge or the experience required to do something like that. If Givology has such a huge network of projects and resources, and most importantly, knowledge at their disposal, they can put these organizations in touch with each other, and these organizations can basically help each other out by giving each other manpower, giving each other expertise, giving each other experiences, everything that they might be missing. Right? So, this is the network, basically. The partners can basically link up through each other, again, through the portal of Givology. Right, the first partnership possibility that we want to address is AIESEC. I'll be honest, the reason this case actually struck my interest is because I read this and I thought, hey, AIESEC is perfect for these guys. So, AIESEC exists in 107 countries. It exists in 5,500 campuses and it has 50,000 students worldwide. That's a lot of manpower. That's a lot of diversity. And if Givology can use AIESEC not as a partner for channeling donations, but as a partner to reach out to local communities, to societies, to projects all over the world, and work with them in order to establish a certain standard for these processes, I think that Givology can be locally responsive and can attain credibility. AIESEC's vision is also in line. AIESEC's vision is actually the realization of humankind's potential, and we think it's in line with what Givology wants to do. The second partnership proposal. Teach for Pakistan is a model that's been founded on the basis of Teach for America, and the basis of that project is basically that the founder basically believes that the root cause of extremism and terrorism eventually is, apart from poverty, it's illiteracy. And it's because of the incredibly dismal state of schools in Pakistan. And the reason, the way we basically got the idea for how Givology can use our network for leveraging knowledge instead of money was because I was talking to the founder of Teach for Pakistan, who's AP site here. And he said that funding will not be such a problem as manpower, knowledge, resources, education will be. Right? Givology can do all that. Givology has the infrastructure in place. All they need is to connect people. They have the network. Networks are valuable. Right? In conclusion, I want to say Givology has been giving all along, but it's time that they kept on giving and started sharing.